Welcome to day two of our free 7-day course, The 7 Rules of Learning Adept English. I'm really pleased you could join me. The format of the course, you know already, every day for 7 days you'll receive an email with a link to a video like this one attached. There'll be an MP3 file so that you can download the audio version to your phone, your mobile device, and there's a PDF file for any words that you don't understand, so a written file so you can look things up. Now, have you remembered rule one from yesterday? Rule one emphasizes that the most important thing in improving your fluency is to increase your understanding, and that we do that through listening. Now, rule two of Adept English is very simple. It says to practice your listening. This will improve your understanding. Now, there are lots and lots of skills that we acquire in life through practicing. So if you are wanting to be good at a sport, doesn't matter which one it is, tennis, football, skiing, practicing is really doing the same thing over and over and over again until you become good at it. Now, what happens when you practice something? It moves between two parts of your brain. Now, if I say conscious means what you were aware of, what you know is happening around you. And unconscious, it's still happening, but you don't know about it. It's not in your mind, you're not aware of it. So, practicing means that things which you're consciously doing, if you do them over and over again, they move into the unconscious part of your brain and you begin to be able to do them without thinking about it. This is key to acquiring fluency in a language. I'll give you some examples. My son goes to a karate class. Now, quite a lot of children, they're quite young, and they learn long sequences of kicks and steps and punches. I've watched them do it many times. I couldn't do what they do, but at their end, they repeat the sequences over and over and over again until they can do them automatically. They do it without thinking about it. Sometimes we might in English call this kind of thing muscle memory, but it's not to do with your muscles, it's entirely to do with your brain. So it's perfectly possible to do this with language learning, and in fact it's what we do when we learn our own language, our native language. Learning to drive is perhaps another good example of this. I don't know whether, like me, you remember your first driving lesson. I remember thinking, oh, what is all this? I can't do the clutch, the gears, the steering wheel, the brake, the mirror, all at the same time. It felt absolutely impossible. But, like everybody else, I had a lot of driving lessons, and over a period of time, it became automatic. Now I'm in the car, I can listen to the radio, I can talk, I can have conversations, doesn't matter. If I'm on a long journey, I might not even remember driving part of it because it is so automatic and it's effortless. I just get in and the car goes. Automatic and effortless. Wouldn't it be nice if you could use these words about your spoken English? Now, if you think about your own language, it's become unconscious, it's become automatic, so much so that you might find yourself speaking in your sleep. If you're talking in your sleep, you're not worrying about getting the rules of grammar correct, but it will be right. So, rule two is about putting in the hours of practice at listening, so that your understanding improves. Now, I suggest that each piece that you listen to, you make sure that you practice, that you hear it a minimum of 5 times. It's useful actually to be able to listen to it 20 times. You may find that difficult to accept, it's a lot of times, but it will certainly become so familiar to you that it begins to become unconscious. What you'll also find is the same will happen to you as happens with children, that you hear enough of the language being spoken that eventually your mouth just wants to say it. So you might hear a child practicing phrases on their own. It's actually enjoyable to make the thing come out of your mouth if you're familiar with hearing it. What kind of listening are we talking about? Well, it's got to be attentive listening. Your mind has got to be on the job, as it were. There's no point doing it if you're falling asleep. Now, you might say to me, listening 10 times to the same thing? How on earth do I do that? Well, one of the things we aim to do with Adept English is make it natural. So I'm speaking to you in a way now that I would use to talk to my friend or my partner or one of my children. I'm not altering the language. I might be slowing it down a little bit to give you a chance to hear some of the more difficult bits, but I'm speaking in a very natural way. We aim also to cover a variety of topics so we can make it interesting, sustain your attention, and also the way there's some things in the other rules. Rule three, for example, will help you with this. How do I do that much listening? We recommend around 30 minutes a day. Now, if you start to spend 30 minutes a day listening to English being spoken, then actually it builds your confidence. If you can listen to 30 minutes of spoken English and understand, say, 80% of it builds your confidence, but it also means that you get away from the habit of translating into your own language. That is a fatal error with language learning. Do not translate into your own language. What you're aiming to do is to start to think in English. So if I'm chatting away in your ear while you're doing other things, you'll start to think in English. It's a very natural way of learning. There's no sitting down and writing or reading. You can just have it going on in your ears while you're doing other things. It's much more effective and it's much more relaxing than learning vocab and grammar in other ways. If you think about it, if you do this listening 30 minutes a day for 3 months, 6 months, even a year, just imagine how much better your English understanding would be after that. What you need to do though to sustain the habit is to find a schedule. This is what rule three talks about tomorrow. We're coming to the end today, but something else that I would like you to do. I'd like you to do a piece of homework. Before you listen to your lesson tomorrow, to rule three tomorrow, please listen to this piece 5 times over. It's not tremendously long, I haven't timed it yet, but it won't be very many minutes. But listen to it 5 times. We'll talk again tomorrow. Have a lovely day. See you then.